Labą dieną. So I'm starting the video by making ducting blast gates. Those parts were rather expensive and they are easy enough to make it yourself, so I decided just build it out of some scrap plywood. The process is self-explanatory. It's just couple of pieces sandwiched together with one moving part in the middle. I'm gluing everything with just simple CA glue with a kicker just to make my process fast, and I tacked everything with a few brad nails afterwards. Here I'm just figuring out how long do I need to make my blasting gate. I cut it to the final length, cut the hole, and you might think that it's rather flimsy, and it actually was, but you will see later in the video I added some extra support, so they came up really strong. And I attached these fittings with the same CA glue. I just used plenty of them and it worked just fine. Here I'm filling the inside cracks and all the openings. And here I'm spraying everything with the mold release because it's wax based and it really helps to slide those pieces. And now I'm starting to do the actual ducting. This process was really, really fun. I had a blast making this. The time just flew. It's kind of like some Lego for adults. You're just fitting parts together. As you can see, every part is loosely fitted, just in case I will have to adjust it. Once my jointer blast gates were in place, I thought it would be a great place to put some brackets to the wall and rest it onto them. So I quickly tack welded a couple of them from some scrap metal. I'm really not sure how I was able to live without a welder before. Anyhow, here I'm just attaching it to this column. There was a ton of rebar inside, but somehow I managed to screw it with some masonry bolts. And once those brackets were in place, I adjusted my pipe geometry and all the fittings and drove a ton of rivets. Actually, not a ton, like 3 rivets into each joint, just in case I will have to disassemble it in the future. I've added blast gates on every machine. That's kind of a crucial step. And another crucial step is to use 45 degrees elbows. You should definitely avoid 90 degree joints at all costs. And as you have noticed, I used a simple straight stick to check my elbow alignment. And when I was securing this second bracket, I lifted the whole junction a few millimeters up just to remove that unnecessary stress from the lower blast gates, because it was jamming a little bit. I bought this panel so used and without any warranty, so I thought I can do whatever I want with it. There were no pipe attachments designed for the lower ducting of the saw, so I just tack welded a few bolts and screwed this pipe bracket and attached the pipe. Here I'm figuring out the junction point for this panel saw. And as you can see, I try to avoid using long pieces of flex pipe because it reduces the suction. And I know I mentioned before that you should avoid 90 degree joints, but there was no other way at this junction because it was so tight and there was no other way than using 90 degree elbow. Here's the only place where I use silicone caulking, because all the connection parts came with the rubber gaskets. So joining the parts was really convenient. And here you can see how it all comes together. And here you can see me gluing that extra support for those flimsy blast gates. And I'm adding a little bit more of that mold release. And this was the most tricky part of the whole build. It was a late night and I really thought that I'm the only person in this building. But it appeared that my colleague was also working late and I could just simply ask him for help. But anyhow, I managed to do it alone and the rest was really simple. Just putting the parts together, adjusting the angles and driving a few rivets to hold it in place permanently. Here's the next day. This is the place where the extractor gonna go. And this 700 kilo shaper had to go somewhere else. So I took the pipes from my pipe clamps, added a few oak planks underneath and just rolled it away. And it's really mind-blowing how much force you can get out of a simple crowbar. You can easily lift, shift and slide machinery with just a piece of iron and some muscle strength. Once I had a clear space, I took as exact measurements as I could and made the whole assembly on the ground. And it's hard to see on the video, but I actually hung this unit on two steel cables. And I double checked if it's in the correct place. It looks like it was. And so here it is, my finished ducting unit. Thank you for sticking with me. I hope you've learned something. And see you next time.